What is up, guys? Welcome to, I guess you would call this week two of off season. So, here's the deal. I am supposed to be training today. Today is Monday, September 11th. And I am not. I talked to you guys in my last video about the knee issues that I was having. And throughout the week, it just progressively got worse and worse. So finally, yesterday, I broke down and I did a teledoc visit. And they prescribed me some, what is it called? Diclofenac, however you say that. It does come in topical form, which I have been using already. But they prescribed it to me in tablet form, so pill form. So I started that today and decided I would take today off to try to give these knees more rest. So I will just be training Tuesday through Saturday this week, hopefully. And we're just going to see what happens. Like I said, this whole knee issue just really started out of nowhere. I was literally fine, and then it was no shitting you, like, I woke up one day and boom, same thing that happened to my neck, boom. I don't know. Anyway, I'm just gonna pray that this anti-inflammatory helps. I was really hoping that they would give me meloxicam, but instead he prescribed that, I think because I told him I'd been using the Voltron cream but I'm going to pray that this helps. And then I may be having to just modify my workouts for a while to not do anything with like squats. I am able to do like some glute stuff. I was able to do leg extensions the other day. They were kind of partials. Hamstring curls didn't seem to hurt. Lying hamstring curls were okay. It's really just like squatting and leg pressing that I seem to have the issue with. I was able to do lunges, but I had to do them in a particular way. But I would probably have to take out lunges, squats, and leg presses. But I'm just going to rest today. I started taking the medicine today. We're going to see how I feel tomorrow and just start up tomorrow and go from there. I have finally caught back up on my sleep. Last night I slept really well. I went to bed at like 9:45, 10, woke up at like a little after 7. I actually didn't wake up until my alarm went off, which hasn't happened in a long time. So that was nice. I'm still having treadmill issues. I just got off the phone literally with Nordic Track support. They're having to send a whole new console, because apparently the console's going out and instructions on how to install it, which is good because I was sitting there thinking, all right, if that's the case and I'm going to have to drop like $500 on a console, I'd rather just get rid of the treadmill and either get a whole new treadmill for $500 or just make payments on a stair mill. But anyway, didn't have to do. So yeah, guys, starting out this week with just resting. And you know, I don't know how I'll feel tomorrow. If I wake up tomorrow and my knees are bad tomorrow, I may just be resting tomorrow too. I may just go walk outside and do some cardio and let that be it. But I've never had knee issues before. Now, I have had knee injuries to where, like, when I was in high school, I almost tore my ACL. Like, it was a severe, severe strain. My knee was, like, swollen the size of a grapefruit for, like, 6 months. But, yeah, I don't know. It just popped up out of nowhere. It's really frustrating when things like this happen. But, anyway, I digress. Here's the girls sleeping. I mean, depending on how I feel tomorrow, I may be taking tomorrow off too. I'm just going to take it day by day. If I do end up taking tomorrow off, then I will absolutely be training on Wednesday. I will just combine workouts, which I kind of already did. And I will just be training 4 days a week. Same plan, just moving exercises around. Excuse me. So, yeah. Anyway, that's where we're at. That's what's going on so far, starting out the week with injuries and a broken treadmill. So, yeah. But we're going to make the best of it. I'm not going to be down on myself. My weight is holding steady at 136-ish. And, yeah, you guys kind of saw my full day of eating last week. That's kind of how things are going to keep rolling for a while. And I'm going to have flexibility here and there. This morning for breakfast, or today, actually, so I'm not training. I'm trying to stay a little bit lower carb. So I bought some smoked salmon, and I had some rice cakes with some guac and cream cheese mix and the smoked salmon on top. It was really delicious. I loved it so much. I had it again, and I just had two rice cakes with smoked salmon, and then I had a yogurt with a little bit of King Line Nutrition cookie dough, and I probably won't eat again until later on this afternoon at some point, and I'm probably going to have a protein shake, and I'm going to have protein ice cream tonight, and that's that. So, yeah. I started doing my stomach vacuums Sunday, so really getting back on my stomach vacuums and slowly just trying to get back onto a schedule and into a routine. Really just not trying to pressure myself into, like, immediately jumping back into stuff, which I've never done that before. I've always just kind of went balls to the walls, but I worked really hard this year, and I kind of need a little bit of a break, both mentally and physically, from doing just set bodybuilding stuff. So I need a little bit more flexibility with the training. I need a little bit more flexibility with the nutrition. And that's not to say that I still don't have goals in mind, because in the back of my mind, I still have my goal set that going into this off season, I need to build again. I need to build overall. I need to build everywhere. So that's still keeping those goals in mind, but just allowing myself a little bit more freedom allowing myself a little bit more freedom along the nutrition side of things. I've stuck with my cardio. I did all my training last week, even with the injuries. I did my cardio to the best of my ability with my injuries. So, yeah, that's kind of where we're at with things. I really would love to go do 20 minutes of cardio today and just go outside and walk, but it hurts my knees to even just walk the dogs. Like, when I'm coming down the stairs, you can hear it crunching. Like, I had Ryan sit with the TV off as I came down the stairs, and he was like, "Holy shit. Like, how did that happen out of nowhere?" So, you know, the last thing I want, like, both of my parents have had knee replacement surgeries. I ain't trying to have that anytime soon. So, yeah, I'm really just trying to be as cautious as possible. But also giving myself a little bit more flexibility within my life, but still keeping my goals in mind, right? So, yeah, guys, that's a quick little chat for you on this Tuesday of me doing nothing. Here in about an hour, I'll tell you what I'm going to do the rest of the day. Here in about an hour, I'm going to go shower. and change, and that's going to be it for the rest of the day. I'm going to wrap my knee in ice and ice it a little bit and continue to put meds on it. So, all right, that's it. That's the update so far. It is Monday, so I'll check back in with you guys tomorrow and we'll see what happens. All right, guys, what's up? I am headed to train. Whoa. I'm headed to train. I'll be honest, I don't want to. It's a rainy day. I just want to stay home and not do anything. And my knees are still fucked up, which makes me have zero motivation. But I did get knee sleeves. I am taking an anti-inflammatory that's supposed to help it. The doctor said, like, it should, like, I should feel better after, like, 5 days, right? So, I'm trying to be patient, you know, because I want to feel better now. So, I'm just super frustrated. Like, I went through all of last year and this, well, I say this whole crap. I've had injuries and stuff, but I've not had any type of knee issues ever, except for when I was in high school, I severely strained my ACL. I think I talked to you guys about this. I had severely strained my ACL in high school. And really, other than that, I've never had knee issues. Like, I might have, like, a weird pain here and there, but nothing like debilitating like this, right? To where I can't do life stuff. So it's really frustrating. And when I say it literally started out of nowhere, I mean, it literally just started out of nowhere. Kind of like my back issue did whenever, I was in prep and I just woke up and then all of a sudden I couldn't move my freaking back. So I'm just super frustrated. Just super frustrated. That's all I can really say. Like the whole prep, it was like one weird injury after another. And then I get back from Romania. I'm tired, but, you know, feeling healthy. And then all of a sudden, I start walking down the stairs and my knees are like, you can hear the crunch. It's like paper ripping. Ugh. So, just frustrated. So, I am headed to train. Please let me make this light. I'm not going to make this fucking light. Ugh. This light only holds for like 2 seconds. I knew I should have went though. So I'm heading to train. I am going to try to hit back and glutes. Within this glute workout, there are lunges. So I may just have to take the lunges out. I ended up doing them on Friday and just kind of being careful, but I don't know. I think I've got walking lunges, and then I've got a kind of like a Bulgarian RDL combo. So I may just be taking those out and doing extra glute bridges, ab and abductions, kickbacks, and single leg RDLs on their own. So, I'll try it with the knee sleeves on and see, but if I start to feel any pain, I'm just not going to do it, and I'll try those first, honestly. So, I'll try the lunges and stuff first. That way, I'll know if I need to do extra on my other exercises. I'll just do that instead, because, yeah, I don't know. I was really trying to stick with this particular program for a good 12 weeks, but I may be having to change it up because of my knee issues. So I may just be having to do like isolation movements and things like that for the next couple of weeks until I can get this knee stuff figured out. I may end up having to go and get a shot. So I really hope not, but I feel like that's what it's going to come down to. Super, super frustrated. Like, I wanted to go into this off season and really kill it. Like, I need more density to my body. Like, I finally have the muscle there, but I need the density, and I don't have the density, especially in my glutes. I don't have the density that I'm looking for. Like, I have muscle and I have roundness and fullness, but I need that density. I also finally have shoulders and stuff, but I have to like round those out more. I need a little bit more within my back. I definitely need the density in my glutes, and I do need more muscle in my hamstrings. So, and that's even without judges' feedback. Like, this is my own personal feedback that I'm giving myself, that I'm saying that I need. So, yeah, that's where we're at. Just don't understand. I'm taking extra turmeric also. Hope this Diclofenac works. I've taken Meloxicam before and it has worked really well, and I could tell a difference in it within like 2 days, but I'm on day two of the Diclofenac, so I'm just praying that by tomorrow I can start telling a difference, because I am supposed to hit, well, no, I'm not going to hit legs tomorrow. I'm hitting chest and shoulders tomorrow. I forget, like, I'm a day off on my training because I didn't go yesterday. So, yeah. Hopefully by Wednesday, when it's time for my next leg day, I'll be okay. And I can do the exercises that I need to do. Like, I pushed through and did it. I probably shouldn't have because I felt pain. But, I mean, I did sumo squats, the compact leg press or the hack squat, and leg presses. But I may have to nix those exercises. It was okay for me to do lying hamstring curl, seated hamstring curl, and even leg extensions, as long as I just kind of did like halves or like 3/4. I didn't go full ROM on the leg extensions and I was okay. But the sumo squats, the leg press, and the hack squat. So, I may just be having to, like, reprogram these next 6 weeks to kind of fit what I can and cannot do. Which, again, I'm super frustrated, but, you know, it is what it is at this point. Alright, guys, I'm almost at True Fit. I'm gonna get in here and hit this back and glutes workout, and I'll let you guys know how it goes. Well, guys, I'm definitely going to have to be modifying my workouts. It just is what it is. I was able to do walking lunges, but the Bulgarians with the RDL combo was a no-go. As soon as I started to go down on the Bulgarians, I started feeling a pain, and I was like, nope, I'm gonna have to stop it. So I was able to do the RDLs, like, that's no problem. I felt it a lot in my lower back, I think because I was just nervous and like compensating. So I'm definitely gonna have to like modify some things, and it is what it is for now. The knee sleeves did help. I think if I didn't have the knee sleeves, I probably would not have been able to do the walking lunges. But it looks like for now, I'm going to be cutting out
any type of squat or lunge movement. So that sucks really bad. Never had to do this before in my life. So it just, it's frustrating. It bothers me a lot because if you guys don't know, I'm going to be turning 40 this year. So it just makes me feel like I'm getting too old for this sport. Which I know I'm not. I know that's just negativity in my mind telling me that. But it really doesn't make me feel good when all of a sudden out of nowhere I just wake up with these like debilitating pains where I can't do what I did before. And it's not always like this. Like in my off season, like I went through my entire off season with no issues. Like no elbow injuries. Like I'm even starting to feel a little bit of pain in my elbows. I really just think it's because I dieted for so long, the long travel time, all the stress, like, and now that I'm back, everything's just like boom. So I think it's just gonna take a bit for my body to kind of like reacclimate and adjust. So it's gonna be okay. It's just super frustrating because like I wanna go into this off season and really try to build that muscle and that density that I'm looking for. Hold on 1 second, ambulance going by. Where are you going, ambulance? Okay. So I think my body's just gonna have to get reacclimated. I'm gonna have to make sure that I stay on my liquids and my fluids, that I really make sure I take my joint medicine. I've not been taking an omega. I need to add that back in. I need to contact Zal and just be like, hey, sorry, on my last order, I meant to order some fish oils. Can I get some fish oils? Yeah, this fucking sucks really bad. But, you know, guys, it is what it is. Like, I'm going to make it through this time. Everything will be okay. It's just, you know, frustrating when you really want to go into an off season and start it off like on the right foot and like just pound your lifting and stuff and really use like that fuel that your body's been missing to like really hit a good rebound, and you're not able to do that. So I think I'm more so just like kind of frustrated and disappointed more than anything. But again, everything's going to be okay. It's just going to be for a period of time. I don't think that this will last forever. Hopefully this Declofenac, I think that's how you say it, will kick in by Friday and knock out this inflammation. If it hasn't, then I'm probably going to be scheduling an urgent care appointment Sunday. And I'm going to go in Sunday and get a shot. So, I don't think I need a shot in the actual joints. I'm just going to ask them if I can get some sort of, like, overall anti-inflammatory shot. Like a cortisone shot or something like that. And see if that helps. So, that's kind of where we're at, guys. Once I get home, I haven't done cardio. I was going to walk Buffy, but now it's starting to rain. So, fuck, I don't know what I'm going to do. So once I get home, I'm going to rework my plan and modify it for like no squats or lunges or leg presses. So yeah, I swear to God, if it's not one thing after another, like you guys have seen, like from the start of prep, I kept having issue after issue after issue. Like first week of prep, severely sprained my ankle. Then I got sick. Then I had the neck injury. Then I had the back injury. Then I had the shoulder injury. I mean, it was like one fucking thing after another. And now we're rolling into this off season, and here I am starting it off with, you know, a little bit of a bummed elbow, but my knee's all fucked up. Like, I'm just so frustrated with the injuries. Like, there's no reason for me to be having these. And like I said, it's sometimes like I will just fucking wake up and boom, there it is. Like, it's like nothing crazy happened the day before. There should have been nothing that caused it. I will literally just wake up and boom, I can't fucking move. So I'm just over it. Anyway, that's where we're at right now. I will check back in with you guys later or either tomorrow, rolling into this week two of off season. Not on a great note, but I'm just going to do the best I can and keep going. That's all I can do. So check back in with you guys later. All right, guys. So hitting chest. As a bikini competitor, you're not going to see many bikini competitors hitting a chest day. Let me explain to you my reasoning why. For one, I love training. For two, I'm hoping at one point in my career, I'll grow out of bikini and I'll be able to move to figure. And number two, whenever I hit chest, I do find that it does work my shoulders, and my shoulders are a weak area of mine. So I only have 3 chest exercises and then I move straight into a shoulder circuit and the ab wheel. So it's not like what I'm doing is anything crazy. It's just in my program. It's what I prefer to do. It's what I like to do. It has helped me build my shoulders. So I'm going to continue doing it. So that's why I hit chest as a bikini competitor. Now, I do what works for me. You do what works for you. I'm going to get started with kind of just an incline press, slight incline here. I'm keeping the weight pretty light. I only have 30 pounds on each side, which isn't that much. And I'm just going to rep out 3 sets of 15. Now, this isn't necessarily for me to build my chest. In all honesty, it's for me to maintain and to hit my shoulders. Or kind of pre-fatigue my shoulders before I actually move into the shoulder circuit. So here we go. Buffy is going to be here with us. Watch out, baby. I got to sit down. Okay. So again, lightweight here. Sorry for the glare of my signs in the background. And we're just going to press. I'm going to start with 15. All right. I'm going to stick with 15. I'm probably going to throw on another 5. I do want to make it challenging. I don't just want to, like, if I just do the exercise and I'm just kind of like rolling through it, I feel like that's not really benefiting me. I might as well not do the exercise at all. So I am going to throw another 5 pounds on and hit set number 2. I really consider that almost just kind of like a warm-up set. All right, another 5 pounds on. We're going to shoot for 15 again. I do have elbow issues, so if I start to feel pain in my elbow, I may not go full range of motion. I know that bothers a lot of people, but look, again, I do what works for me, you do what works for you, okay? All right, that felt pretty good. I'm gonna throw another 5 pounds on. So this will be my last set of 15, gonna throw another 5 on, make it a little more challenging, and then move on to the next exercise. All right, so we've got 25, 30, 35, 40 on now. That's per side. Ugh. All right, there we go. That was great. Okay, so I am going to move to a flat press now. So I usually pick either a machine or dumbbells. So I'm going to do machine today. I'm going to stick with this multifunctional machine that I have. And after I finish the flat presses, I'm going to move into flies with it. So, and then that'll conclude the chest part. Then we'll just move to shoulders. So here we go. All right, guys. So I'm going to hit a flat chest press on this. I got that where it needs to be. Hold on. Let me see this. Yeah. All right. So I'm not going to be taking this attachment off. To be honest, I'm just being lazy. I don't feel like it. Plus, there's no sense in it. This isn't going to hit it anyway. So same thing. Probably going to hit 4 sets of 10 on this one. And see if I can't work my way up with each set. Yeah, this feels pretty light. Yeah, that was way too light. So I'm just going to immediately go up and wait here. And I'm going to sit right back down and hit another set. All right, guys, again, second set was pretty light again. So I just went up and weighed again. That one was more challenging. Still didn't kind of get close to failure. I have a feeling though, once I go up this fourth time, that'll be good. And then we're going to move to pretty much pec deck, except on this, which is a little bit awkward, and I'll show you guys that. So I'm going to do it again. And you can see on some of these, I'm not taking a super long break in between. I'm not one of these people that feel like you need to take a minute or a minute and a half break in between. I feel like you take a break, and then once you feel like your body's recovered, then you start your next set. Now, I'm not saying that for everyone. Like, if you're a newbie in the gym, you're probably going to want to get some experience behind you before you just kind of roll into exercise or set after set, exercise after exercise. But this is what I found works for me. Once again, I tell my clients to do what works for them. For some of them, I do say, hey, you probably do need to take a little bit longer because I want you pushing heavier. For others who've been with me for a while, I know that they probably don't need as long. So we usually take like 30, 45 seconds. So anyway, moving on. Last set here. That still felt pretty light. I know I can probably go heavier than that. I probably will next week. I did start feeling a little bit of elbow pain though as I was doing it. So it's probably best that I didn't go quite as heavy this week. So to turn this into a fly, I just flip this over and do that. Now I do know that the fly on this machine is a hell of a lot heavier than most gyms, and even with the pressing. So I'm just going to start with 2 plates. I'm gonna hit three sets of 15 right here. Again, I'm not trying to do anything crazy for chest and shoulders. I'm really just trying to get blood flowing, get a good pump going. And then I'm gonna move to my shoulder circuit. And I will explain like my shoulders to you guys once I get there, but I'm gonna hit 15. Some say put your hands here. I feel like this is super weird. I don't do that. I do put my hands right here though. And I'm probably going to stay at this weight for all three sets because, like I said, for some reason, pressing on this, I can go super heavy, but when I get to the flies on it, maybe it's because of the multi-pulley cable system. It is a lot harder than it is like on the ones in the gym. So we're just going to stay right here. I'm going to finish these sets out and then move to shoulders and show you guys that. Oh, while I'm doing this, here's my pre-workout. So this is Zao Nutrition, Light Up Extra, and their creatine as well. Zao is now offering creatine. So use my code, CBERKS20. It'll be in the description below. But I use the Light Up Extra, and the Light Up Extra only has 100 milligrams of caffeine in it. So it's not like it's anything super crazy, okay? So it doesn't get you all like tweaked out like most pre-workouts do. And then they just came out with their creatine about a month ago. So I ordered some of it because I do take creatine all throughout off season and all during contest prep, 5 grams. So that's what's in here. I'm going to down some of this and then I'll finish the rest before I even finish my workout. And these little bottles come in so handy. I got them off of Amazon for like, I got them in a pack of three for like 10 bucks. All right, guys, I'm getting set up for my shoulder circuit here. I'm just going to do 25s on each side. And I'm, I do this in a circuit. So I'm doing shoulder press, plate front raise, and then plate laterals. But I'll probably just use dumbbells. Just because usually if I'm at the gym, it's just easier for me to grab plates than walking all the way across the gym to, sorry, that was loud, to grab dumbbells. Sorry, I'm out of frame right now, but just bear with me. So we're going to do dumbbells instead. Okay. So machine, shoulder press, and I'm about to get this set up. Of course, if I was in a gym, this would be an actual shoulder press machine. Not that this isn't an actual shoulder press machine, because this is a machine of many functions, but you get what I mean. Okay, so I have had the most difficult time building my shoulders. And for the longest time, I could never get a pump in my shoulders. I never felt exercises in my shoulders or anything like that. So one day, Ryan and I were working out and he was like, I was like, take me through a shoulder workout. So he was, and he was like, I just don't understand how you never get a pump. He was like, you don't feel a pump from any of this that we're doing. And I was like, no. So he sat on the lateral raise machine and he was like, I just want you to do this until you feel something. So I literally did like 100. And that was the first time, literally, I shit you not, the first time I finally got a pump in my shoulders. So after that, I was like, you know what? I really felt that in my shoulders. It felt good. I'm just going to start doing circuits and see how that works. And ever since I started doing that, I started feeling it in my shoulders. I started growing in my shoulders. I don't know. If you guys have watched any of my videos from the past, you know that my shoulders are like my weak point. Like they are my kryptonite, they're my Achilles heel, all of that. And finally, this year, I feel like I've gotten them to grow by doing the shoulder circuits. So if you watch any of my shorts or anything like that, just realize if I'm hitting shoulders, those exercises that you're seeing back to back are all in a circuit. So this that we're doing today, I'm going to be doing 5 rounds of 20. Okay. I know that's high volume. Some people are going to like shit on this method and all that kind of stuff. I don't really care. It works for me. I'm all about finding what works for you. So that's what we're doing. So we're going to hit presses, front raises, and lateral raises. Okay. And my weight throughout this will not change. I will keep the same weight the whole time. Now, I will say, I do try to go up in weight. Like, normally I use 10s, and these are 12s. Let me scoot this over here. So, it's not like I don't try to go up in weight. I do. It's just, I do what I can. Oh, lighting is shit. I have terrible lighting in here. I just need to bring my O-ring light back. I'm going to put you guys here. Okay. So we'll hit front raises and then side raises. And I do a neutral grip because it just feels better on my elbow. Ooh, there we go. Yeah, I see you guys already feel that pump. And it's been a struggle for me for so long, for so many years, to get a pump in my shoulders. So this is the way that I've found that works for me, to where I feel it. I feel my muscles working. I feel the blood flowing. I know it's not like the heaviest of weight or anything like that, but I've done like low reps, heavy weight. I've done lighter weight, higher reps. I've done time under tension. Like, I've literally tried every method. I've tried different types of laterals. I've tried doing rears, like everything. And doing it in the circuits like this is the only thing that has truly like helped me like grow my shoulders. So on my full shoulder day, I have 2 circuits like this. So yeah. Anyway, I'm going to finish these circuits out and then hit some abs. All right, guys, last exercise. I only do 1 ab exercise, and it's usually the ab wheel. If I do another exercise that's not the ab wheel, it's probably just a weighted crunch or something like that. So I have pretty good abs already. They're pretty well developed. There's not a whole lot more density that I need there. In fact, I think I've developed my transverse abdominis so much, I really need to more so shrink it. So I've been doing vacuums and really trying to be conscious throughout the day of like just standing relaxed and letting my belly pooch out, and really trying to keep it sucked tight all day long. I've even considered possibly wearing a waist trainer in the off season, although
So my phone just fell. It's fine. We're gonna do this. Where was I at? So I've even considered wearing a waist trainer in the off season to help me stay conscious of keeping my abdominals sucked in and not sitting so relaxed. Because I think for a long time I did that so much that I developed like this lower abdomen pouch, this pooch. And it's not like, if you feel it, it's hard. It's not like it's fat or anything, but yeah. So I'm really trying to stay conscious of that. The debate's still out on if I'm gonna wear a waist trainer during the off season, but yeah, whatever. For now, we're just gonna roll on with doing our ab wheel and being in our vacuums and being conscious of keeping the belly pulled in and not letting it distend. So for abs, same with shoulders, I just hit 5 sets of 20, and then with this workout, I'm done. I don't go down super low on these either. And I just realized I still have my belt on. Take your belt off. Guys, 4 more sets of those and I'm done. The reason I do the ab wheel is because I really feel it hits everything. And I try not to do any type of oblique stuff. Because I feel like those get worked in everyday life. And I'm not trying to build my waist out wider. I'm really trying to keep it nice and slim and trim. So, alright guys, I'm going to finish these out. And that's it for this workout. Hope you guys enjoyed this. Hopefully my phone won't fall next time. Alright guys, so I am on cardio, finishing out this week. Doesn't hurt my knees to do stairs, like going upstairs, just coming down. But, heads up, I was supposed to check in yesterday. It didn't happen. I got busy with stuff and both Ryan and I forgot. But I am up in weight. I am now like 142, not mad about it, not upset about it. Honestly, I feel like I'm holding some water, but I still have abs. I'll post a picture in here for you guys. I'm still pretty lean on my upper body. I just feel really like swole and tight. I don't know, it's a weird feeling. Like I kind of feel like I'm holding water, I kind of don't. I don't know. I have had some digestion issues this week only because I changed my last meal from protein ice cream to protein pancakes, so I think that kind of affected me. And then also, Emily
gave me some lactose-free Greek yogurt. And it fucked me up. Like, my stomach was so messed up yesterday. Come to find out, I was reading the back, and it's got live cultures in it. And I think that really, like, took me down. So, anyway, I'm not going to be having that anymore. So, that's where we're at. I still have abs. I just feel a lot fluffier. So, yeah. Still dealing with the knee issues. Even though I'm taking anti-inflammatories. Brian thinks that my big jump in weight could be from inflammation and from being on meds. I don't really know. What I do know is I do at least still have abs. I do have quite a bit of definition, so hoping that it's just my body trying to regulate. So, yeah, I'm not mad about it. It just, it is what it is. So, yeah, guys. So, that's pretty much it for this video. I hope you guys enjoy the Mic'd Up training. And, yeah, I'll check in with you for the next week of off season. And we'll go from there and see what that week brings. Hopefully, my knees will be better by then. My treadmill needs a new console. So, they're sending me a new console for it. So, hopefully, I'll get it sometime next week. And yeah, we'll go from there. I will check back in with you guys in the next one. Hey guys, so I'm just hopping on here, finishing out this video because I think I forgot to mention that the reason that Ryan and I think like my weight spiked so dramatically from, Thursday to Saturday is because, or is it Wednesday to Friday? Whatever. I went up like 4 or 5 pounds over 2 days. We think that's just water retention from the medicine that I've been taking for my knees. I don't seem to be holding any in like my face or cheeks, but I definitely feel it in like my hands, my arms. Like I can just feel like I'm holding on to like water. So I don't know that I mentioned that. I may have, but I at least wanted to like get on here and throw that out to you guys. Like nothing has really changed within my, like, food or training or cardio even. So that's the only thing we can account for is that it's probably the diclofenac that I've been taking. And I did read up on some sides and it does say water retention. So I have stopped those. I don't think that they were helping anyway. I took them for a week. Literally saw zero difference. So I'm pretty sure there's something else going on with my knees. It may just be tendonitis or I don't know. I don't think it's inflammation at this point because I'm not swollen. It's not painful to the touch. Like, it's just certain movements. And I'm pretty sure it's like my patella tendon that's like going over my knee. So anyway, we'll just deal with it and go from there. But I at least wanted to get on here and just throw that out there that there was literally nothing that we changed. So that's the only thing we can account for. So yeah, guys, I'm still like really happy with how I look. I still have abs and all of that, even with like feeling like a little bit bloated, from the water retention. So, we'll see what happens in this coming week with not taking that and just kind of staying on my meals, doing everything same. So I just wanted to throw that out there before this video closed out.